This is Old India Radio, Shillong, the Northeast News Bulletin read by Arkin Pariyat. The Sikkim Krantikari Morcha government will soon clear the decks for the CBI to take up corruption cases in the border state. A notification issued by the erstwhile Sikkim Democratic Front government in 2010 had mandated the Central Probe Agency to seek its prior consent before taking up an investigation against any of its officers or public representatives. The SKM had pledged to bring the CBI to Sikkim in its election manifesto, with the former Chief Minister Pawan Kumar Chamling being its prime target, as the then opposition party had accused the latter of indulging in embezzlement of public money during his 25-year rule. The Guwahati High Court granted interim bail to Mohammed Sanullah, an ex-army man who was detained as a foreign national. Hearing a petition, Justice M. Bhuiya and Justice P. K. Deka also served notices to the centre, the Assam government, the Defence Ministry, NRC authority and the investigating officer of the case, and gave them 4 weeks' time to reply. Mr. Sanullah had been detained by the police recently and sent to detention camp following the verdict of the Foreigners' Tribunal. After retiring from the army, he had assisted the Assam police. The court, however, told him not to move out from the jurisdiction of the Kamrup Metro and Rural District without the prior permission of the Border SP of the Assam Police. The Northeast Frontier Railway has been able to harness 2,300 kilowatts of solar energy during the last financial year, thus saving a sum of 1.88 crore rupees in the process. Official sources said that while Guwahati has already become the first fully solar-powered station, in the Northeast Frontier Railway, off-grid solar plants are being installed in as many as 41 other stations all over the zone, totaling a capacity of 1,140 kilowatts. Out of these 41 stations, work is already completed at Barahu, Sonabari and Amoni stations of Lumding Division, while the plants in the remaining stations are to be commissioned by December 2019. Aizawl will soon become a plastic-free city, according to officials of the Aizawl Municipal Corporation. AMC Mayor PC Lalmingthanga said that framing of a bylaw which will ban single-use polythene bags and other plastic products of below 50 microns has been completed and is awaiting approval from the state government. The bylaw will come into effect from the 1st of August this year and will be enforced in a stricter manner from the 2nd of October, he said. However, plastic products allowed by Plastic Waste Management Rules 2016, which are recyclable, will not be banned, he added. According to Lalmingthanga, the AMC has constituted a committee on plastic-free city headed by Councillor Lalming Moya to monitor ban on plastic products of below 50 microns. Additional Director General NCC Northeastern Region, Major General Bipin Bakshi, met Meghalaya Chief Minister Conrad K. Sangma at his office chamber in Shillong yesterday. The Chief Minister was briefed on the NCC matters pertaining to the state of Meghalaya and the requirement of NCC expansion in the plain belts of Garo Hills. The Chief Minister expressed satisfaction with the work being done by the NCC officials in the state and assured all-out government support for establishing NCC Academy and shooting range in Meghalaya. He also asked NCC to forward proposals for creating sporting culture in the state, keeping in mind the upcoming national games to be organized in Meghalaya in 2022. The nascent regional political party, belonging to the National People's Party, which leads the coalition in the MDA government of Meghalaya, has been recognized as a national party by the Election Commission of India. The commission, in its order issued yesterday, granted recognition to NPP as a national party. Further, as per the request of the party, the symbol book has been allotted as the reserve symbol for the party. The NPP has fulfilled the criteria to qualify as a national party after winning 5 seats in the recently held Arunachal Pradesh Legislative Assembly election. Former Lok Sabha Speaker Purno Agitok Sangma founded the National People's Party in January 2013. And with that, we end the Northeast News Bulletin, which came to you from the Shillong station of All India Radio. Have a nice day.